Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen, here on the campus of Prairie View A&M University. The Panthers getting ready to take on the Tigers of Grambling State. Charles Porter, along with Donald Carroll, and of course Mia Greer, my personal assistant and boss, as the Panthers get ready to take on Grambling State. Man, it's going to be a good one here. Grambling State coming in just like the women at 9-3 in conference play. The Panthers 5-7, battling for that eighth spot. We've got to win out. We've got to keep our nose to the grindstone if we want to get in the tournament. Still got a chance, but if we don't get on back on track, it's going to be slim here as the Panthers get ready to take on these Tigers. The starting lineup for the Tigers of Grambling State, starting a junior from Lynette, Alabama, number 0, Kentavious Dozier. Starting at guard, a sophomore from Montgomery, Alabama, number 4, Antoine Burnett. Starting at guard, a graduate student from Shreveport, Louisiana, Trey Michael Morton, or Mouton. Starting at guard, a senior from New Orleans, Louisiana, number 11, Jordan Smith. And starting at forward, a senior from Kaduna, Nigeria, Jonathan Aku. The head coach for the Tigers of Grambling State in the seventh season is Dante Jackson. His assistant coach, Kyle Jones, Darius Walker, Cameron Prather, and Jerome Graves have done a fine job for Grambling State. They currently sit in the number 3 spot. Let's make sure, folks, the number 3 spot in the Southwestern Athletic Conference standings. And they keep it up. They'd be the third seed. If we had to go now, they'd be the third seed. Let's check and make sure here, folks. If you want to watch all of, you want to get all of the statistics, Southwestern Athletic Conference statistics, all you got to do is go to www.pbpanthers.com, or pardon me, www.swag.org, swag.org for all of the current Southwestern Athletic Conference stats. You can go there and see the standings, the statistics, the schedule, whole nine yards. So, in the basketball conference, in the standings right now, Southern is the top of the conference at 10-2. Grambling State, number 2, at 9-3. Alcorn State's 8-5. And then there's a tie between Bethune-Cookman and Jackson State. Bethune-Cookman beat Jackson State at 7-5. So that's Jackson, Bethune-Cookman, Jackson State, Texas Southern, Alabama State, and Pine Bluff. A&M and Prairie View are battling out at the bottom for that eighth spot, with both 6-6 records. And now the starting lineup for the Panthers of Prairie View A&M. Starting at guard, a graduate student from Eatonville, Florida, number 1, Charles Lane Jr. Starting at, well, we're going to just call him center. He's the postman. A junior from Shreveport, Louisiana, Brian Miles. Starting at guard, a graduate student from Atlanta, Georgia, Charles Smith IV. Starting at guard, a graduate student from Houston, Texas, Javonte Hopkins, and Nunley, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Andre Nunley, the graduate student from Euless, Texas, will get the start at guard. We're going to go with a 3-guard rotation, Horton, Hopkins, and Nunley, and Miles and Lane. Well, let's see, that's 3, 4, 5, yeah. We'll go with Hopkins and Nunley. We'll bring Horton off the bench here. Should be a good one. 20 minutes on the clock, folks. I want to thank everybody who watches us and share this video. Please share, share, share. Tell a friend to tell 10 friends to tell 10 about exciting Panther sports. Right here on the Prairie View A&M University YouTube channel and Splendid Media Live. The head coach for your Prairie View A&M University Panthers in his 9th season is Coach Byron Smith. His assistant, Spencer Robertson, Jacob Galindo, and Todd Shelton. Miles getting ready to jump it off at center court with Jonathan Aku. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to get this one underway. The Tigers control the tip. Mouton has it up top. Nunley will be on him. They give it up now to Smith. Smith kicks it over right side to Kentavious Dozier. Dozier brings it left, kicks it in the corner now. Jordan Smith puts it up from 15, no good. And coming down with his first rebound is Brian Miles, who leads the conference in rebounding, averaging 8.9 per game. Hopkins now gives it over to Smith. Smith brings it right side with the fall away off the backboard. Yeah, he called that one, kissing it off the glass for two. Beautiful shot. Well, okay, yes, ma'am. Those of you watching on Splendid, we've got to turn it off. You can go to the Prairie View University YouTube page to catch all the video. www.youtube.com and just put in the search bar Prairie View Athletics. And is that Aku that fell to the floor? Aku on the floor. Good sportsmanship there from the Panthers. Miles going over to lend a hand. Nunley gives it up now to Lane. Back over to Miles. Miles looking left side now, gives it over to Smith. He started the scoring off with a beautiful two-pointer off the back of the board. Didn't even have to call that one. Lane, the crossover, steps back, puts it up, hits the back of the iron, no. Good-looking shot, just didn't fall. Dozier comes left. Kicks it up top, gives it now over to Burnett. Back out to Dozier for three. Dozier a little too hard. Nunley slaps it away. Lane saves it in to Nunley. And Nunley quickly gets it up to Hopkins. Hopkins coming around the right side. Hopkins finds the baseline. Can I get a roll? Oh, he says he stepped on the line. Great move by Hopkins to get the hit the baseline. We're going to stay back the other way. And Grambling State will get the ball back. 17:44 left to play here in the first half. 2-0, the Panthers on top of the Tigers. Burnett with it left wing. Aku setting the pick. Coming back left side is Mouton. And here we go back left side. On the baseline was Burnett, but shot clock violation because the Panthers with that clamp down defense. 17-19 left to play, 2-0 to score, the Panthers. On top of the Tigers here in the early going. Nunley, the alley cat, brings it quickly up. Kicks it left side, Smith sizing him up. Finds Miles and Miles. Oh, man, just a little too hard with it. Aku, right side, double pump for two is Jordan Smith, the senior from New Orleans, Louisiana. Tied at two here in the early going, folks. Nunley comes left, Lane now. Taking Burnett on the dribble. Cut off. Great job. Smith now working on Smith. Wide open. Miles thought about the three-pointer. Now takes it. Oh, man, he gets a roll and has it thrown away by Smith. Good block. Here comes Dozier. And, yeah, send it back the other way. Here comes the rebound. Quickly out to Dozier. Dozier just runs over, and here comes the alley cat with the block. Not going to see many blocks from the Alley Cat, but he got a hold of that one. 16-19. Left to play near in the first media. Smith brings it left side. Nunley with the hand. Gets it out of bounds. Aku puts it up for two. Jonathan Aku, the 6'11 senior. McCaskey getting ready to check in. McCaskey with some good numbers for the Panthers. Smith finds a hole, fades it away, too short. Hopkins tries to get it, no. 4-2, Grambling leads. Here comes Dozier. Dozier brings it around the right side. Great hand again. Another steal. Here comes the Panthers. And personal foul, Hopkins takes it to the cup. And the Panthers will get it. Media timeout here in the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers are down by two, 4-2. 15:30 left to play. Low scoring first half. Stick around. We'll be back with more.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word. It's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gaughan. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence, as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
To Prairie View, Texas, ladies and gentlemen, 15:30 left to play here in the first period. The Panthers down 4-2, very low scoring first half, ladies and gentlemen. The rebound in the Panthers are getting out, being rebounded by the Tigers by 4-6-2 in the rebounding category. Three turnovers for the Tigers of Grambling State, who average 13.3 turnovers per game. The Panthers right under them at 12.7. What is that, a half a turnover? Or a turnover and a quarter, three quarters of a turnover to be right dead even with each other in the turnover category. First shot is away for Hopkins. It's good. The Panthers doing pretty good from the charity stripe. We talk to Coach Byron Smith all the time. He wants to be shooting around 84%. The Panthers coming in tonight shooting around 72%. Way downtown are the Panthers, and checking in and sneaking in for him was Jordan Smith. Smith couldn't find the hole. Hopkins slows it down, gives it out to Smith, and there's Miles with a big one off the backboard over Antoine Burnett. 5-4 to the Panthers on top. Moulton will give it back up to Dozier. Back right side over to Moulton. Moulton looking right, working on Smith, puts it up. Powell, face job. Right side, Hopkins quickly up. Now to McCaskey, left side to Charles Lane. McCaskey working, coming right side, looking, finding the hole. McCaskey bringing it out to Lane for three. Back of the iron, no. 6-5, Tigers up one. Dozier has it going around the pick set by Aku. Here comes Dozier, and Miles is going to get called for that first foul. Got to be careful here. Well, no, they give that one over the Lane. Lane got him first. And then helping out on the backside there was Brian Miles. Didn't need him in foul trouble. First shot is away. It's good. 7-5 to score. Second shot is away from Dozier. Rattles in and out. Here come the Panthers. Quickly up the right side lane in the middle. We've got to slow it down. Hopkins kicks it right side to McCaskey. Hopkins wants it back. Hopkins brings it to the baseline, throws it over the right side over to McCaskey. Jump ball there from Miles. Miles can't finish there, and we'll go back the other way, 13-34. Dozier. Left side to Moten, and McCaskey picks up the charging violation. Here comes Horton for McCaskey. Orlando Horton Jr., the freshman from League City, Texas. Horton right side now to Smith. Now to Lane. They've got the shooters in. Hopkins comes around, looks for Horton, and he's going to be fouled. Dozier, is it double zero? We're going to give that one to Dozier or five? No, they give that one to, yeah, five, Moton. Checking in for the Grambling State Tigers, number three, Mikael Stevenson, sophomore from Fort Wayne, Indiana. And one. Miles with the turnaround. McCaskey's going to come right back in. For Hopkins or Horton, no lane. For Hopkins or Horton, no lane comes out. That was pretty good. I said for Hopkins, not Horton, no lane will check back out. And Horton will stay. Just trying to get Miss Greer into sports announcer mode. Burnett works on Horton. Here comes McCaskey. They get it right side. Turn around. Nice shot there at that time by Jordan Smith. And the Panthers get the rebound. Here comes Hopkins and slapping on the rim. That's a tip. Slapping the backboard like that. Lane back in for McCaskey. The Panthers will get the ball back. Horton and Hopkins on the wings. Smith to bring it in. Dumps it over to Miles. Now back out to Smith. Oh, wanted to give it to Miles. Now he takes it baseline. Steps back. Thought about the baseline. Turns. Twist. Gives it back over to Miles. Miles on the wing. Gives it back up now to Hopkins. Hopkins working around the left side. Hopkins turns. Twists from 20. It's partially blocked. Miles can't tip it in. That's an easy one. We got to have those. 8-7. The Panthers up one. Stevenson, left side down low now to Johnson. Johnson turns around, hands it in the middle to Smith, and there's a foul call. And that one's going to go against Charles Lane Jr. That's going to be his first personal. CJ will come out. McCaskey will check back in for defense. Here comes Gazelius. And checking in for the Panthers, McKinley Harris, the senior from right down the street in Richmond, Texas. Trying to see where, there he is right there. There's a Papa Harris over there. Smith at the line for free throws. Shot is away. He puts it in there. Three-point play good. Now the Tigers up 2-10-8 in a very low-scoring first half, folks. Horton to Gazelius, back over to Hopkins, over to Horton. Gazelius. Now here comes Hopkins on the fast break. There's Miles. He puts it up for one. Well, two. 12 minutes here in the first. We're tied at 10. Stevenson gives it back up to Dozier. Dozier coming around the right side, man, with a strong move. Cupped it. And, man, the rims aren't friendly for either team here. Here's Hopkins with a turnaround. Puts it up. Up and under. He's going to be fouled. And they want a traveling violation. But Jordan Smith is going to be on 11. Let's see. Nope, that's going to go on 10. That's going to go on Jalen Johnson. And Johnson, when we come back, we'll have the foul, and we'll be going to the charity stripe to shoot free throws, folks. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball after this important message.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU is all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G? And as a proud sponsor of HBCUs.
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Well, welcome back to the Knicks Center. Jeanette Jackson trying to get in here with us. JJ, here you go. I'm trying to get Jeanette.
Hey. What's popping, everybody?
Tough loss for the Lady Panthers. I tell you, I've been waiting on you to come so I can take some of your dinner here.
Oh, yeah. You want some?
I'm just teasing. Man.
Oh, man, that was a tough one
that
for us.
That was a tough one for us after playing so well on Saturday night, getting real close Saturday night, and then coming here to Grambling State. They came in 9-3. We know that they were a good team.
Yeah. They came in sitting at the second position.
Well,
but
actually third, really. Third position. You got Pine Bluff at the second position, Jackson State at the first position. But, man, just couldn't get it done. We are really missing Waddle. If we had Waddle in there, I think it would have been a different story. And, of course, Smith, not Smith, but Lewis, is also out.
Yeah.
So we got two of our bigger rebounders.
Our impactors.
That are out of the game.
Defensively, and, yeah, who can help us close out a game and get better. We just have to continue to get better, though, with those two young ladies sitting out. We have to continue to execute and I just believe in our bench because, I mean, believe it or not, we've been having great sightings.
Absolutely.
We've been having really great sightings, and that's the up part, and that's the wave that we're trying to ride right now.
10:52 left to play. Just checking in was Terrence Lewis for Grambling State. He had a big three-pointer. Now the score 13-11. The Tigers up by two.
Oh.
Quick one down low to Brian Miles. Miles gets him up and under, and one. Yeah, and one that one. Let's see what the official says. Count it. No, one shot. Yeah, and one. He didn't push the and one exclamation point. But gee whiz, you know, the Panthers really needed that win. Now
yeah.
we're gonna have to wish some things in other places happen.
Yeah, we just gotta figure out a way to execute, man. We had crucial moments towards the end of the game where we could have got over that hump, but we just could not seem to execute. And we had a key player who was kind of off our game a little bit. But, you know, You live and you learn. Those are just learning moments
who's off
for
their
us.
Game? You got Smith played a good game. She's second leading scorer with 16. We'll get back to it in a minute.
Yeah.
Let's get back on to what's going on with these men here on the right side. Great defense by the Panthers. Stepping out now, there's Stevenson. And Stevenson coming in a little warm with another three-pointer. Here comes Horton. And a lot of sweat on the court. Horton to Hopkins over there. Now the lane. Miles tries to put it up, and he's fouled, and he goes surfboard on the ground there. Seventeen fouls for the Tigers. You guys could not capitalize on the bonus all night. The Tigers were in the bonus most of the night.
Yes.
In every quarter, they beat you guys to the bonus. We couldn't finish.
We couldn't seem to get to the basket.
We couldn't get to the free throw line. I mean, we were 14 of 23 for the night to shoot
60%.
We got to do better than that.
We got 23 attempts, and we only capitalized on 14.
That's the 7 points we're missing. Also, we got killed in the paint. Clobbered 36-16. 10 more points in the paint. That's Waddle right there.
Straight line drives, that extra help defense. Yes, Waddle was missed for sure with that.
So Waddle and Lewis should be able to return after protocol Wednesday. Is that correct? We ain't supposed to talk about it. Let's just shut up and back to live action. Here we go back. I've already got a 1-2. Stevenson up top now working right side. Gives it over to Burnett. Kicks it back now right side to Lewis. Lewis back to Stevenson. He can shoot it. Hits the front of the iron. No. And Nunley steals it away. Here comes McCaskey. Over to Horton. Back out to Hopkins. Back out to McCaskey. Thought about the three. Oh, man, transition.
Oh,
that would have been beautiful.
That would have been a good shot.
He should have shot it.
He was in motion.
Had the full turn and everything. Horton at the wing, back over to Hopkins now to McCaskey. Down to 12 seconds on the shot clock. We've got to make a decision. Here comes McCaskey in the paint, kicks it back out to Horton. Horton for three, hits the back of the iron, no. Well, I mean, Coach, he had 4 seconds left. So
yeah, this is a really
somebody's
intense
shoot
game.
16-15, wide open, Coffer for two, no. Stevenson, man, way up there. And has made an immediate impact in there, attributing for 6 of the last points. Or the last six points for Grambling.
Yes,
yeah, okay.
Yes.
There we go. Let me get it right, Charles. Horton, Hopkins, three, looks good. No. Panthers can't go cold from the field now. 3-point edge. If they score here, Coach, you take a timeout or what?
If here comes they score, we have to take a timeout and just let the guys get them a little.
Stevenson outside. Well, we get a break there.
Decompress.
Yeah, we get a break there. Lewis has to go out of bounds off his leg. Lane and Smith will check back in. So Lane, Smith, McCaskey, Horton.
Coach doing a good job right there making his rotations without having to utilize one of his timeouts.
Miles down low. Aku wants to keep him cut off. Here's Lane. Lane takes it on the baseline. Stops. Spins. Gives it over to Smith. Smith gets a birdie. Now brings it back outside. 14 seconds. Here comes McCaskey. Oh, my goodness, McCaskey. Trying to go for Horton there in the corner.
And that's a pull-up.
Yeah.
That's a pull-up right there.
Absolutely. You got to shoot that one.
You have to. That's two shots that he done passed up.
Well, you know about a little bit about shooting, right?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Better check the record.
Better check the record. Let me see. How many games did you have left when you were a 1,000-point performer? Boy, that was midseason, huh? Here we go. Left side, inside. And foul called on Charles Smith. That's going to be his first personal. Panthers have got to get it going here and push it here. Push it down the court and see if we can get something going here, ladies and gentlemen. 7:57 left to play here in the first period. Stick around. This is exciting Panther basketball on the PVAMU and the University Panther Sports Network.
At PVAMU A&M University, excellence isn't just a word. It's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button, because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. We better get this going, else the Splendid Media crew is going to drop off here. Hopkins checks back in for the Panthers. .757 left to play. Both shots are good. And now Grambling State, folks, is up by four, 19-15. Here comes McCaskey over to Smith. And bye-bye. Aku knocks that one way out of bounds.
Hey, Pop. You want to turn my mic back up, Pop?
Yeah, I'm sorry,
that's
dear.
That's how you was doing.
Pardon me. The Splendid Media crew was about to get out of there. I want to send a shout-out again now to Michael Urban, who's he's listening. Yeah, Mike, he's listening to the game and watching the game on the phone across over there in the
where's he at?
On the floor seats in that black warm up there. I'll show you in a minute. Miles gets it now. Ah, oh, throws it away. Stevenson with some big hops. Here comes Stevenson in the open court.
That's
He'll slow it down.
The ball.
Stevenson, right side, he's gonna work on McCaskey. Left side, here comes Stevenson. Dozier runs the baseline, trying to get Aku in there. Mismatch with Smith on him. Dozier just stops and pops it for two. Now the Panthers down by six. We got to do something here. We need a score.
That's it. We've been in a drought.
Smith backs it out, gets it over to McCaskey. Left side, now to Lane. Lane to Smith. Now, there we go with three. That's off the mark. But right there is Brian Miles. And, man,
ready to clean it
he
up.
He is a beast under there.
Ready to clean it up.
That's why he leads the Panthers in rebounds. And Byron getting a little intense, and rightfully so. Come on, guys. We got to get it done. Gazelius is on the bench. Man, Gazelius has been real quiet this year. Hadn't really had that breakout game. Well, we just waiting for him.
Oh.
And, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Well, sometimes you got to do that. Antoine Burnett gets one off the backboard, and Miles just a little late on the block.
Yeah.
But it looked good.
Yeah, that was a statement.
Yeah, but
right there.
It looked good.
I ain't going to let that go in.
What does it say? Have you ever watched The Equalizer?
Oh, yes.
Okay, so that means I'm here. Let me see if you remember that scene. McCaskey back up right side. Now kicks it left side. And Lane loses
it. Get that stop.
Stop the ball and.
What was it
called?
What
happened? A tech? What? Oh, hold on, let's see. White four. McCaskey with the tech? Uh oh. No, four?
No,
Smith.
Four. Yeah.
Smith with the tech? Well, let's see what the play is, and we'll go back to the replay. Dozier's going to shoot the technical shots. But let's see what goes on here. All right, here's Smith. Smith gets fouled right there. So Smith, yeah, he said happy birthday too loud. And that resulted in a technical foul.
crucial moments, though.
Okay, yeah, that's
crucial moment.
You gotta be able to keep your head.
Yes.
24-17 now, 7-point lead. And Grambling gets the ball back. We gotta make a stop here, guys. Here comes Hopkins. Kicking it down low to Aku. Aku right down in the middle for the big dunk.
Help side was just a little too late.
Well, there was no help side. That's what the problem was. 5:44 left to play here in the first half. Gazelius, come on, man, shoot the ball. Horton shoots it in to Hopkins. Hopkins turns, twists, really quick in there, quick as a cat. Give it back over to McCaskey. McCaskey back out to Horton now. Gazelius now for three. That's okay.
Shoot
the ball.
Yeah,
keep shooting it. Keep shooting it. Stevenson brings it up, slows it up, brings it left side. Aku and, Hopkins getting bullied over there and hooked by Terrence Lewis, the graduate student from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Grabbed him around there, hooked him with the shoulder, and Gazelius right out. Gazelius for offense. Horton, and they bring in the alley cat, Nunley.
Energizer Bunny.
Hey, man, we call him the alley cat. I asked him, where'd you find Nunley? He says he was in the alley, and he said he fed him, and he just wouldn't go home. So he asked him to be on the team. Lane for three. Oh, man, look how high Hopkins is. And Nunley.
On the floor playing defense.
Still fighting for it. Well, that should have went the other way. Here it is. Look, there's Nunley getting on the floor, kicks it with his hand.
Look at that. Look at that. Still getting stopped.
That goes out. That goes out on that goes out on Stevenson. Well, Grambling will get the possession. 4:54 left. Stevenson. Coming up around the right side. Stevenson weaving, bobbing, finding the hole. Has to give it up to Burnett. Burnett with the dribble drive and one. And Burnett slow to get up. Nunley will come and have a seat, man. Golly gee. 11-point edge by the Grambling State Tigers. Lewis, is that 24 at the line?
I think that's just four.
That's four. I'm sorry, folks. Pardon me. Antoine Burnett. Yeah, 63% free throw shooter. Checking in for the Tigers, Jordan Smith, the senior from the NO. Horton in the corner to Miles, to Horton, to McCaskey. Hopkins. Horton turning, twisting. Lane with it now. Lane hadn't been able to get into it. Down 8 seconds on the shot clock. Miles shoots it over the horn.
Oh, man.
Smith in for Horton. 4:10. 4:10 left to play here in the first half. Stevenson.
Oh.
With a nice crossover.
Oh, wow.
Man.
Nice pull up.
Ugh. In and out.
Better rebound. Run with him.
Hopkins.
Run with him. Oh, man. That's another.
Yeah, it should have went straight to the bucket.
Yes.
Here comes Smith. Throws it out. Horton for three. Yeah. We needed that one.
That was a big bucket for
Hopkins,
us.
Hopkins, rather, for three. They'll cut that lead to 9. Stevenson with a good push in the middle. And Aku with an easy
man.
Bucket.
Can't afford to trade buckets right now.
Yeah, you can't. We gotta play some better defense. Gotta keep him from under the bucket.
Absolutely.
Hopkins to Lane. Lane looking for Smith, gives it over to Miles. Miles thinking about it. Miles wants to work on Aku puts it up from 15, no. Stevenson now with it. Down to 3 minutes. Stevenson crosses over right, and Hopkins
picks up that foul. What is that, his?
That's two on Hopkins.
Second, yeah.
And the Panthers, man, are going to have to do something here, folks, if we want to get back into this one, folks. I tell you. Stick around, folks. We'll take a break here. Media timeout in the Baby Dome. 2:56 left to play. The Panthers are down by 11, 31-20. 31-20 is the score here in the Knicks Center. Stay tuned.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Welcome back to the Knicks Center. Charles Porter and Jeanette Jackson, coach.
Yes, sir.
Big news.
Big news.
Well, what does that do for us? But basically, and the news is Alabama A&M beat Pine Bluff.
Yes.
We beat Alabama A&M, so.
Right now, that ties us for seventh place. It's a three-way tie right now, seventh place. So what that looks like for us is we have to go and we have to get these last four games.
Yeah, absolutely.
We have to go and get those last four games.
Well, we've got Alcorn, Jackson, Texas Southern.
Yes.
And Pine Bluff.
Yes.
We go to Pine Bluff.
We go to Pine Bluff, yes.
We can do it.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, no doubt about it.
We can do it.
No doubt on
we
our
got,
minds.
See, we have to go down there and shock them. We got to go down there. They're not going to.
We're a better team
think,
now.
Well, they're going to think that they're going to be able to just play us like they did last time. But you know your coach.
We're a better team now.
Your coach's going to do her homework.
Oh, yeah.
And she's going to be ready for us. But so is our coach. We're going to do our better homework.
That's right.
We got to get those games.
We have to. We definitely have to. And the way our girls are playing right now, is no doubt in my mind that we'll be able to do so.
I think we're playing with on a different mission here. And we'll talk about it in a minute as the Panthers throw it away again. That's when we're looking at the turnovers here. The Panthers with, well, that's not it. Seven turnovers? That can't be right. Up top, left side, Moten.
Oh.
Stops.
Come on. Good defense.
Kicks it in the corner now to Lewis. Lewis now back up now to Jalen Johnson. Johnson from five puts it up no.
Great defensive Smith. Possession for us.
Yeah, Smith and Miles almost lost that one. Hopkins right side. Lane wants it in the corner. No. McCaskey back over to Hopkins. And Hopkins will be fouled. Looking at here comes McKinley Harris. Nine fouls for the Tigers here again. The Panthers have to capitalize on these bonus points.
Absolutely.
I mean, the Panthers, I mean, the women's team had a rough time with the bonus. And now we're having a rough time capitalizing off of the bonus.
Yes, we are. Right now, shooting 62% at the free throw line.
2 minutes left here in the first half of play, Charles. The Panthers got to get it done. I'm talking to myself because I'm trying to figure out what I can telepathically communicate with Brian Smith.
Well, it must have worked Byron because we just got a bonus point, as you call it.
Well, this is where we're getting beat.
Yes.
Right now, the women were beat on the free throw line. We were getting beat on the free throw line. Too many turnovers. And trying to just do
not
too much.
Not capitalizing on our opportunities.
Trying to do a little too much. Man. The urgency was too urgent.
Yes.
Can we say it like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Poised.
Here we go.
We must be poised.
Right side with it, Burnett. Travel, no call. Stevenson looking down low over to Johnson. Johnson working. There you go.
Help side.
There you go.
With
the call,
good
coach.
Help.
Good call, coach. Here comes Hopkins now. Hopkins puts it up off the glass. Yeah. Man, can we have it?
Man,
the Panthers love it. Dozier. Oh
yes.
Yeah. Now. He helped him with the flop. Look at it.
It was the extending of the arm.
If
you
James
gotta,
Hart, he's been watching a lot
sell
of
that, right?
He sold it.
He sold some tickets.
I'm telling you, he could have traded that for a Super Bowl ticket. That performance was great. Lane Hopkins, 1:24 left to play. 24-33. Yeah, not anymore. Lane finally heats up here at the end of the game. That's his first three-pointer of the game. First shot of the game. And that's going to cut the lead to 5.
Just like that, it's back being a ball
Just like that,
game.
It's back to being a ball game.
That's
You're right.
right.
Absolutely. 30-second timeout, ladies and gentlemen, here in the William Nix Center. Now, we're anticipating exciting Panthers softball this Wednesday. Y'all will be here.
Yes, we will.
You need to bring all of the ladies out and support Coach Vernon Bland and Joseph Lane and Alexis Bandon.
Oh, you know we'll be out
AKA Peppermint Patty.
We're all about supporting one another.
Well, the ladies are already calling me about the walk-up songs. Okay, this is what I want you to say because, you know, that we do the walk-up song thing there. And we're real excited about it. Lady Panthers, back-to-back Southwestern Athletic Conference softball champions. Going for a three-peat, an unprecedented. And so, I take that back because I think Mississippi Valley three-peated a year. I'm going to have to get Mia here on her laptop when she comes instead of just being on her phone.
Yeah, he said he needs you to do some work.
So we can get these statistics that we're talking about. You took her headphones, so she
no, came. She gave them to me.
Gladly too. Did you see how willingly?
Hey, you want these?
How willingly she gave those?
You know I'm not gonna shy away.
Those I know you not. you got your start broadcasting where you're sitting right now.
Here we go back now.
Here comes Stevenson now. Up on McKinley Harris with some good defense.
Oh, man.
But just
offense.
That's just a hell of a shot.
That was just better offense.
1 minute left to play. Harris with some good defense. See how high he was?
Yes.
Here we go. Left side now. Smith back over to McCaskey. Right side now to Hopkins. Over to McCaskey. Thought about the dribble drive. We want the three-point shot.
Come off of that.
Smith wants it.
Come off the screen.
Smith wants it badly. And the kickball reset. Checking in now for the Panthers. Here comes Lane. Harris will come out. Gazelius will check in. Man, I'm waiting for Gazelius to hit that way big Steph Curry type of three-point shot. And the crowd is going to go nuts. They're going to go nuts.
That'll be exciting.
Yeah, they're going to go nuts if he does. Here comes Hopkins now. Down to 35 seconds on the shot clock. Hopkins. Looking for Lane. Gazelius is wide open now. Thought about the three. Kicks it left side now. Gives it over to us.
And one.
Yeah. I like it.
Now we need that and one. We need that one.
35-29. That 1 point will cut the lead to 5. And that's a good comeback. That's good heads-up basketball by the Panthers. Not panicking. And not letting their head hang.
It was really great spacing right there. And he read the open area of the floor very well. He moved as the ball moved and stayed in the open area. You couldn't help but to see him.
Smith.
Good job.
Cuts the lead to 5. Here comes the alley cat Nunley. Here comes McKinley Harris for some defense. Miles is out there. So you got Hopkins, McCaskey, Harris. And Hopkins.
Last possession of this half.
Dozier working on McCaskey. Doesn't want to stick that elbow out there on McCaskey, but they're going to get a one-on-one situation but McCaskey try to dump it up. Here comes Dozier.
Good defense.
Dozier pushes off again. Way to recover. Stay in front of him.
Stay down.
Hey, oh. Jump ball. Come on. Well, let's see. Here comes Dozier. He turns, comes around the right side. Horton actually reached in there.
Had he kept his hands up, it would have been a solid, solid possession of defense right there.
Dozier at the line for free throws. Out of the way, the score is 6 now. ...36-30... the score. Dozier with one more, and the Panthers will have 5 seconds. He'll hit it. That's a 7-point lead. The Panthers with 5 seconds left to play. Munford will check in. Zahad Munford, the graduate student from Dallas, Texas, had a lot of time last year. Here come the Panthers. Hopkins on the left side. Lane wants it. Hopkins shoots it up for three. Yeah, at the buzzer beater. And the Panthers go in with the buzzer beater. Hopkins with the beautiful running jumper. Folks, we got to see that one again before we get out of here. What a shot from the Panthers. Here it comes. Down the middle. Here comes Hopkins. Booyah! Wow, what a shot, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers go in.
down
by four, ladies and gentlemen. We're almost down by 7, but man, what a finish for the Panthers. Stick around. We'll go to our studios for halftime and then come back with the exciting second half. Thanks, Coach Jackson, for sitting in with us here in the first period.
Thank you for having me. It's always a pleasure.
We'll talk to you next time.
Absolutely.
This is exciting Panther basketball on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word. It's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Yeah, Tommy meant to drop that bag and get some lemon licks. Tommy means to pop outside with all the wood. Tommy HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gall. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you could take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button, because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen, the Panthers. Man, on an exciting last shot to take it to 5, 37-33 is the score. The Panthers are shooting 44% from the field. The Grambling State Tigers, 56.5. The Panthers, 42.9% from the three-point range, 40% for Grambling State. The difference is the reboundings and the turnovers. The Grambling State Tigers have rebounded us 16-11. and added a couple of extra assists to that. Two extra assists. The Panthers are trying to get back into the winning column. 16 and 11. Total points, Miles leading all scorers with 14. Devontae Hopkins with 11. Eight on the other side of the ball to Jonathan Aku. Six rebounds for Aku. He is dominating the paint. And Miles with five, one better or one less. So the Panthers left with momentum. So let's see what they'll do, ladies and gentlemen, here in the second half. Want to thank our friends over at Woodlawn Entertainment for just the great video that they do here for Prairie View A&M. You guys are going big places, and I'm going with you. Here we go, back right side. Charles Smith now gets it over to McCaskey. Thought about it. Now Smith. Now Smith will have it on the left side. Smith taking it over now to Miles. Miles from three-point range. Whoa! Miles with a big three-pointer. The big man can do it. That'll cut the lead to one, 37-36. The Panthers come out. Aku kicks it right side. Gives it over to Moten now. Here comes Barnett over to Jones, or is that Smith? That's Smith on the right side now. Dozier on the baseline working on McCaskey. Turns around. And it gets stuck there in the rim. The Panthers will have it. What? Wait a minute. Okay, that would mean the possession hour. That's like a jump ball. So the ball gets stuck between the goal and backboard. It's a jump ball possession. What happened? Wait a minute. How does that work? And they get a reset? Well, 20 seconds on the shot clock. Grambling will keep it. McCaskey working on Dozier. And, yeah, Miles. And they give it over to Aku. No help in the bottom. We make a great play there. Great defensive play. Can't capitalize on it. 39-36 to score. Three-point edge. Right side with it. McCaskey left to Lane. Lane now over to Hopkins. Super hops for two. Hopkins, man, I tell you, this kid can jump out of the gym. Moten, right side back up to Dozier there on the wing. Here comes Moten. Steps back for three. Hits the side of the iron, no good. And Hopkins walking to get Horton out of the game. Horton just kind of sitting there looking for him to call a foul, and, man, Byron is livid. Here we go, right side with it, Smith. Now to Miles, back over to Smith. They look to try to find Lane in the corner. Ah, and, man, gee whiz. And the Panthers, oh, my goodness, blow one. 43-38, five-point lead. We were on our way, Harris. So Miles will be going to the line to shoot free throws. There's the shot, and Aku will get him on the left arm as Horton gets ready to come in with Harris. Hopkins is probably going to come out with Lane. Miles, Lane will come out with Smith. They'll leave. Hop in. Miles. Second shot is away. It's good. Well, Miles doing it all. Burnett brings it up. Working on Hopkins to kick it down. On the right wing there to Smith. Smith wants to work on Harris. Harris with some good defense. Here comes Burnett to work on Hopkins. Puts it up and a foul on Hopkins. Grambling very physical with their play tonight. Up off the bench, Lane and Smith. Burnett to the line for the free throws. First one's away, it's no good. Aku will take a seat. Smith will check in. Here comes McCaskey at the top of the key, coming right. McCaskey looking on the wing now, gives it up to Lane. Lane with a dribble drive in the corner to McCaskey. Shoots it out on the right side. Lane gets a birdie, steps back, now shoots it from 15. Yeah, that's what we need. Burnett has it top left side, gives it up now to Dozier. Dozier working on McCaskey, goes around him. McCaskey on him like gloves. And McCaskey wanted the charging violation. Refs letting him play. Hopkins comes left wing, crosses over, gives it up to McCaskey. Finds the hole. Oh, tries to shoot it in to Smith. Just trying to do a lot, McCaskey is. Lane and McCaskey will come and take a seat. Nunley will check back in for the Panthers. Nunley working on Moten. Here comes Moten, throws it way up and out of there. And yeah, it's going back the other way. Harris with some good defense. And here comes Lane for the offense. Nunley is going to run the point, brings it up. Looks right side, there's Lane. Back up now to Smith. Left side, Nunley. Right side to Hopkins, back out to Smith. Smith wants to work on Dozier, comes back left side, Lane now. Sizes up Burnett, takes him on the left side. Miles. Hopkins down to 4 seconds on the shot clock. Got to do something with it. Hopkins. Oh! Puts it up. Deep three-pointer. Wow. 46-45. The Panthers within one now. Big shot for the Panthers. Smith travels. No call. Burnett wants to work on Charles Smith. Mouton puts it up from way deep and a double pump from Lewis. And Lewis is going to be fouled. And that's going to take us to a media timeout, ladies and gentlemen. 10:15:07 left to play, man. This is an exciting one. A one-point game, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers need to push it and keep it going here. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button, because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Welcome back to the Knicks Center, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers getting a little bit better back in the paint now. They've upped it to 14. Still getting destroyed in the paint, folks. 26 to 14. Turnover ratios off of points are the same. 9 points off of turnovers for Grambling and Prairie View. 8 turnovers for the Grambling State Tigers. 9 for the Panthers. The Panthers 10 of 13 from the free throw line to shoot 76%, 51.7%. From the field. Grambling, pretty darn good themselves. 10 of 14 to shoot 71%, 54.8% for the game, 17 of 28 shots. Hopkins takes it right, finds a lane with a double pump, puts it off the glass. No. Hopkins, where's no foul here, huh? Burnett wide open for three. And pops it. 51-45. That's a bad call down there. No foul. Here come the Panthers. McCaskey with it left side. Gets it out to Lane. Lane for three. Boom. Yeah, trading threes. Back at you, baby. CJ Lane with a big three-point shot. 14-23 left to play here in counting. 3-point edge by Grambling State. Coming right side with it. Well, now left is Burnett working on Lane, muscling him, putting him all the way down. And coming down with the rebound is Miles out to Hopkins with the Euro step. And that's going to be goaltending. Hopkins. Here comes McKinley Harris for defense to get Lane out. Good job by Lane with the big 3-pointer. Now Harris playing some quality defense. 51-50. Panthers battling in here. Moten wants to work on McCaskey. Smith back out to Burnett. Trailing Quentin Murrell. And Burnett. Burnett at the top of the key. Comes left, right. He wants to try to thread the needle. Puts it up. And one. They're going to give it out on Harris. And a foul. Hey, Harris with some good defense there. Hopkins didn't come over, didn't push through the defense and come over for help. And Harris had to commit the foul. Burnett. Shot is away. It's good. 3-point play. 54-50. Tigers up 4. Hopkins. McGaskey, Hopkins, Lane. Down to Smith. Smith. Turns, twists off the left side. Hopkins way up there. Miles, man, fighting it, putting it in there. Ah! Yeah! Great shot that time by Miles. 13:08 left to play. Aku is going to have to come back in. There's no answer from Miles. Miles just handling Jordan Smith, the sophomore from New Orleans. Moten from the left elbow. Ooh, it's two. .12:45 left to play. 56-52, a 4-point edge. Lane looking left side, wants it, gets it to him. Here comes Smith. Smith puts it up from 5, no good. And the Panthers trying to hang in here. Trey Michael, Moten has it at the top. Moten coming left side at the elbow, stops. And a late whistle. McCaskey, that's going to be 2 on McCaskey. and Horton will have to come back in. Miles still in, man. Miles playing very smart, very well for a big man. Only one foul for Miles. Miles with one, McCaskey with a couple. Hopkins has three. ...57-52, a five-point edge. Shot is the way, it's good. Hopkins to Smith to Lane. Lane takes it baseline from 15. Puts it up. No good. And the Panthers will get it. Burnett trying to go after it. Can't get a hold to it, and the Panthers will take a break here. 58-52, a six-point lead here in the William Nix Center. Panthers have got to get it together here. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball after these important messages.
This here's a champ for all the fellas. Try to do what those ladies tell us. Get shot down because you're overzealous. Play hard to get females, get jealous. Okay, smarty, go to a party. Girls are scantily clad and showing body. A chick walks by, you wish you could sex her, but you're standing on the wall like you was Poindexter. Next day's function, high-class luncheon. Food is served in your stone-cold munching. Comes on, people start to dance, but then you ate so much you nearly split your pants. A girl starts walking, guys start gawking, sits down next to you and starts talking. Says she wanna dance cause she likes the groove, so come on fatso and just bust the move.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
The Panthers keep getting so close, but just can't seem to get over the hump. 58-52, the score, a six-point edge. The Panthers will have it, though, and get a chance to cut the lead to four, maybe three. Lane. Hopkins wants it. Lane cuts it over on the left side. Horton thinking about it now. Here comes Lane with the dribble drive, kicks it back out to Hopkins. Hopkins steps inside, loses the ball, and we're going back the other way. Here comes Burnett to slow it up and wait for some help. Burnett in the corner. Moulton thought about it, now gives it back up to Burnett. Burnett's playing some good ball. Moulton comes around the right side. Aku sets the pick. That's just textbook. Hopkins with an up and under for two. ...11 minutes left in this one. Hopkins fighting through the pick. Moulton just threads the needle, go right by him for two. 62-54. Here comes Hopkins. Hopkins loses it to Smith. Lane thought about the three-pointer. Hopkins wants it. Lane takes it. Oh, man, good-looking shot. Just didn't fall for him. 8-point edge here by the Tigers. Burnett coming around the right side to Mural. Jump shot, Lewis, no. Miles brings it down, gives it over to Lane. Lane looking in the corner. Hopkins is wide open over there, just begging for it. Hopkins standing way over there in the corner, all by his lonesome. All by his lonesome. McKinley Harris pops up off the bench to give Lane a breather or Smith. Smith to Miles to Hopkins in the corner to Horton on the baseline. Horton from 15, yeah. .953 left to play in this one. Muriel has it on the right side, wants to work on Hopkins. There's a mismatch there. Burnett on the curl, wants it. They're looking left side. Stevenson has it now, wants to work on Hopkins. Drops it down to Aku. Jonathan Aku working on Miles, and Miles gets him with the body. Two on Miles. That one should be on the floor. Well, Aku at the line for free throw. Shot is away. It's good. .63-56 the score. Now 64-56. 8-point edge. Hopkins. Up top left wing Lane. Waiting in the wings for it. Lane gets it now and puts it up. Told you. Three-point shot, no good. Harris can't come down with it. Horton tries to steal it from Burnett, but no. Burnett brings it left side, spins, has it stolen away from Hopkins. Here comes Hopkins and Horton. Horton to Hopkins for two. Great job. 58-64, down to a 6-point lead. Muriel on the right side to Stevenson. Up top to Aku, down to 7 seconds on the shot clock. Here comes Stevenson. Oh, wow, ref. Personal foul. Hopkins pleading his case over to Byron. 8:31 left to play. Stevenson. At the line for the 3-point play, yeah. Horton to Hopkins. Stop, spots, puts it up, and he's going to be fouled. Three shots. Fouled on the 3-point shot. Hopkins will have 3 free throws. McCaskey will check in for the Panthers. And we're going to take a look at the last shot, the foul shot. And we'll take a look at it, ladies and gentlemen. The 90th running of the Prairie View University Relays is coming up here in March. 23rd and 24th. I'm going to go back and make sure Miss Thurston came over to correct me. I think I said 22nd, 23rd. It's the 23rd, 24th. I'm going to go. Here, all you got to do, folks, if you want to find out the schedule, all you got to do is go to our webpage here. And Hops is going to be shooting 3 free throws while I get this one up here. www.pvpanthers.com for all the latest news and information on Southwestern Athletic Conference sports as well as Prairie View. PV Relays the 22nd and the 23rd. The 22nd and the 23rd. That's what it has here. PB relays, 22nd and 23rd. Hopkins can't hit the last one. 67-58. 8:25 left to play. Hopkins will have one more. Hopkins. Shot is away. It's good. Okay, down to an 8-point lead now. Again, the Panthers can't seem to overcome this 8-point. Here we go across the timeline. Burnett has it right side. Stolen by Miles. Miles lays it off the glass for two. Man, I love a big man that runs the floor. Wow. Well, now the Panthers down by six. McCaskey, he just can't win for lose. That's good hustle. You know, you get to a point to where you're trying to do so much to try to get us back in it, and you end up, gee whiz, having a rough time, ladies and gentlemen. Well, 7:59 left to play. Plenty of time. 67-61. The Panthers down by six. Stick around.
Hey, Don. What made you become a cricket campus ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you could take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen, on the campus of Prairie View A&M University, located in beautiful Prairie View, Texas. 7 minutes, 59 seconds left to play in this one. The Panthers still getting just beaten in the paint. 32-24. 32-24. The Panthers with 10 turnovers. The Grambling State Tigers with 11, way up under their averages. The Panthers shooting 52% on 22 of 42 shots for tonight. The Tigers, 23 of 39, to shoot 59%. Quite a bit better than us. We've just got to hit some shots. We've hit some big shots to keep us in it. We've just got to stay in it. If we can stay close, I think last few minutes we'll go ahead and make amends of things. Second shot is away. It's good. Now it's an 8-point lead again. Here comes Hopkins back over now to McCaskey. McCaskey looking up right side. Lane has it. Now back left side to Hopkins. Hopkins looking inside. Cross court to Lane. Back over to McCaskey. 16 seconds on the shot clock. Plenty of time. No time to panic. Look for the good shot. Here comes McCaskey. Back out to Hopkins for three. He's wide open. No. That's the shot you want. Good rotation of the ball there by the Panthers. Wide open, left side, Lewis for three. Terrence Lewis, the graduate student from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Lane, the McCaskey, left side to Hopkins. Hopkins to Lane. Lane backs it out. Throws it back to Hopkins, and here comes Smith on the baseline. Smith with a reverse layup. No, can't find anything. Yeah. And Burnett scrambling for it. And the Panthers will get it. 6:52 left to play. Lane's going to come out. And Horton. McCaskey in to Miles. Miles with a good shot there off the glass. Miles working on that double-double for the Panthers. Miles with 23 points. Hopkins with 23 points. Left side, Aku has it. Gives it back up now to Moten. Moten coming right side. Good defense, spins around. Nobody over there on the right side. Everybody trying to make a big steal here. McCaskey will have it at the top of the key. McCaskey left side, Horton. McCaskey over to Smith from 15, yeah. Little easy one. Here comes McKinley Harris. Timeout on the court, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers have 6 minutes to get it done. Down by 9, 74-65. We'll be back.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
We're back live. Courtside here in the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers just can't seem to get over that hump. 9-point lead, 74-65. Aku has it at the top of the key. Miles working on him. Knocks it away. Backcourt. Oh, Miles touched it. Oh, wow. Moten coming around side with 7 seconds on the shot clock. He just has to throw that one up there. Here comes McCaskey out to Hopkins. Hopkins threading the needle, putting it up, and he's going to be hammered. Hopkins will go to the line for free throws. Smith will pick up his second personal foul here. That's going to send Hopkins to the line. Well, folks, the Panthers will hit the road this Friday. Head towards Pine Bluff, Arkansas. For Monday's game, going ahead into Mississippi Valley State first. They're going to get on down to Itabena. Well, they'll take on, first of all, Pine Bluff on Saturday and then Valley on Monday. There was a misprint in one of the news publications. They had them playing Pine Bluff on Monday and Valley on Saturday, but it's vice versa. Right side with it. Straight down, trying to thread the meeting. Taken away by Byron Miles. Brian Miles gets it outside. Over to Hopkins, and it should stay on our side. Oh, wow. We just can't win for lose tonight. Every time we go on a run. 74-67. 7-point edge with 5:11 left to play. Jordan Smith kicks it back left side. Aku. And nobody's out there to get the rebound. Aku chases down his own rebound. Dozier for three. Yeah. Wow. Can't win like that, guys. We got to get back in transition. Got to get back and play some defense. Hopkins coming left side. 4:34 left to play. Now the Panthers really getting kind of lazy. Hopkins. Man, Hopkins has hit the ground so many times today. Here comes Dozier. And Horton will be called for the foul. Well, I tell you, Miss Mia Greer, who's a basketball aficionado, she really is, and she's not very happy, Crystal Edwards. I want to say, send some shouts out to my main man, Mark Anthony Spivey. Donald Rogers is watching along with Denise Prather and Dalton Benton. Thanks y'all guys for watching and listening to Exciting Panther Sports. Here comes Brian Miles, kicks it back up, but now to McCaskey. McCaskey outside, Horton to Hopkins. Here comes Hopkins in the baseline. Skips it to McCaskey. Horton takes it baseline. Can I get a roll? Oh, it rolls right out, folks. In and out, no good. Gee whiz, we just, oh gosh, folks. 3 minutes, 50 seconds left. Still time left, folks. Dozier coming left side, coming around the pick, sit by Aku, and Harris from behind clobbers him. And now we go down to the final media timeout, ladies and gentlemen. Gosh, don't know what to say, folks. Panthers are hanging in there, though. Fighting to the very end. Stick around. We'll be back with more. Exciting Panther basketball.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gall. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center. Send a shout out to my mom, Lola McIntosh. Staying up late, way past her bedtime there, Mia. I said my mom's bedtime. Oh, she said you don't have a bedtime because you're in college now? I'm going to call Erica and see what she says about that. I'm on your side. I'm on your side. 3:29 left to play. Aku at the line for free throws. So very proud of Mia. Doing very well in school here. And now coming with old Uncle Charles to try to make a little change.
At Prairie.
Make a little change. He said, Uncle Charles, you ain't gave up nothing yet, DJ. He said, you ain't gave nothing but a some pizza and some popcorn. That ain't going to do it. We're coming back down the other way. Hopkins, 10-point lead. We still have time here. We just got to get a couple of stops. Here we go with Miles there on the left side. Miles wants to work on Aku. Miles taking him to baseline, and he's going to be fouled. Aku can't handle the footwork of Miles. Harris playing some quality minutes. Checking in is going to be Lewis. And Aku will come out. McCaskey into Miles. Miles with the power. Turn around. Puts it in and out. Man, he grabbed the net. Come on, ref. Moten brings it right side. Moten turns. Slides it over. And a foul. That one's going to be on three. They're going to get that one on Miles. Miles with the clobber. They're on the Panthers. I want to mention some of our super fantastic, terrific students other than Mia Greer, my assistant. Bailey Anderson is a kinesiology major from Houston, Texas. She's one of the basketball managers. Wonderful young lady. Tricoria Anderson, who is the women's basketball manager and the president of the Gold Members Club. I want to send a shout out to Latoya Campbell. That's her mom. She always listens. Mia Bradley from Greenville, Mississippi, is doing a fine job for us, too. She's a ticket taker, and she does a great job. McCaskey on the baseline loses it. Oh, gosh. What can we do? Can't win for lose here. 2:28 left to play. Here comes Moten on the right side working on McCaskey. Tries to go around. McCaskey says none of that and takes it away. Here comes Horton. Puts it up off the glass for two. 79-69. 30-second timeout here on the floor. Well, are they going to call it a 30-second and stretch it to a full? Is this the last timeout? The last full timeout here, ladies and gentlemen. In the William Nix Center. Stick around. Right about we'll come now, back and wrap this one up.
You're about to be possessed.
Here in the William Nix Center.
The sounds of
stay tuned.
MC Raw Face and DJ Easy Rock.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. 2:14 left to play. James Crenshaw is going to kill me, but I just had to play that one for you, DJ. Little Lakeside there. They're very familiar with Lakeside in Mississippi. James Crenshaw, CEO of Woodlawn Entertainment. They can do just about anything. We'll give you the numbers here in a few minutes. Up top with a Dozier, left side. Lewis for three, no. But right back to put it back in is Burnett, and the Panthers just want to let this one. Seems like they just want to let this one out. Hopkins. Oh, wow. And Lewis. And it's still, and you can't say that out loud in front of everybody that can hear you. 83-69, and that sends the Nunley. Here comes Miles. Yeah. And Miles hits it. 71-83 the score. Down to a minute and 17 seconds. Left to play in this one, folks. Golly gee willikers, we let another one, another great opportunity to get away, the men and the women's team. Folks, just don't know what to say. We've got the talent and we've got the coaching. We just got to put together two halves for the men and four quarters for the women. And, yeah, they're going to call that one on Dozier. Now, watch this. Here comes Dozier. Now, watch. Dozier is going to go for it. Bowes, and then comes back down with another arm. They need to look at this one. He leads with his elbow and then comes down with a forearm. Forty-five seconds left to play. And up in the air, Harris. It's popped upside the head, man, with an elbow. And Harris's brother is standing up. Folks, I think we call it hoorahing. He's Harris's brother's in the stand with their pops, and he's standing up and saying, "Get up! Ain't nothing wrong with you. Hit you in the hair. It didn't hurt." 41 seconds left to play in this one, folks. Well, again, the Panthers will head to the Pine Bluff, Arkansas. A must-win this weekend, folks. We still got a shot. Both teams head to Pine Bluff, Arkansas, and then out to Greenville, Mississippi, home of Mia. Where's Mia's last name? One of our students. I'll let you know in a minute. She's from Greenwood, Mississippi. And that's going to do it, folks. Gee whiz. Pine Bluff, 5:30 p.m. matchup. And for the men on Monday, it's an 8 p.m. matchup. Must be an HBCU Go game or ESPN game. Here comes Hopkins with the dunk. And gee whiz, folks. Just not enough time left for that expended energy here. And the Panthers are going to drop two at home, folks. Wow. Gee whiz. Panthers catch another rough one, folks. Final score, 74-83. Byron Smith's on the way over. We'll get his final comments and wrap this one up. Two more games here in the William Nix Center. Jackson State's got to come to town. And ladies and gentlemen, Alcorn State. And that'll wrap up our season. Going to try to do the Texas Southern game down at TSU. And it's in a few weeks. And then that'll wrap up the season. Exciting women's softball is on tap as the Lady Panther softball team get ready to take on the Bison of North Dakota State. We'll let you hear the school song here and then come back with Byron Smith. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Coach Byron Smith is about to get ready to come over and we're going to chat with him. It's been a rough go of it, folks. The Panthers, gosh, had an opportunity. Just couldn't make it happen. The final score, 83-74. And, man, what a rough time here in the William Nix Center. Coach, thanks for joining us. I know this is not a happy time. The Panthers, man, got so close. It just seemed like every time we went on a run. And I'm sorry, Coach. I'm going to just say it. I got in trouble last week. Might as well keep it 2 weeks. Might as well be consistent.
Yeah.
The officiating kept putting us out of the game.
Right.
Every time we make a play, right, it seems like we get a call to take the win out of ourselves. And that's very disappointing.
Yeah, I think, being in this head coach 8 years and being in this league for 10 or better, you think that, you have a little bit more of
respect, help. I mean,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah, so I don't know what to call it. I don't know what we've done to – but every time it's a questionable deal, if it's out of bounds play, it always goes the other way. So, I don't know. Maybe I need to take the refs out for lunch or dinner.
No, we better not do that. We're in trouble. First of all, I want to thank our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who's the head of our life.
Absolutely.
And we start that off every time you and I mm-hmm. – that's our moniker. So
absolutely,
we're gonna do it right, man. Brian Miles is just – the best big man in the Southwestern Athletic Conference, no doubt.
Yep.
Another double-double
yep.
for Miles. And, I mean, he just plays with a lot of passion. I mean, gee whiz, without Miles, I don't know what we'd do. We just couldn't get Hopkins. If we could ever get Lane and Smith on the same page with Hopkins,
yep,
man, we're unstoppable.
They have a good team. Just, it's just the inconsistency, of your guys. And some of these guys, they've never really tasted winning, Charles. And, obviously we have here in years past, and we know what it tastes like. And you want to get back to that space. But unfortunately, a lot of these guys that we have on this team have never really been in a winning space. So they don't really – they hadn't tasted it. And so, again, when you've tasted it, you want it so bad. You do anything to get there. But I just think we've just got some guys that just have underachieved and hadn't really stepped up into big moments. But, hey, we still love them. They're our kids, and we're going to keep pushing them, keep coaching them. They're somebody's children, right?
Hey, they're our kids while they're here. We're responsible for them. And Coach, you do a great job of mentoring these young men. The game, the tail of the game is the rebounding.
Right.
31 out of 20.
Right.
That killed us in the paint,
yep,
38-34.
Right.
We started matching up towards the end of the game. We started really fighting for those rebounds down the stretch, but they got off to a good start in the paint, and we just couldn't catch up.
Well, I mean, they're teetering on being a first place team. They've kind of where we were. They're consistent. They win tough games, and they're well coached. Dante Jackson does a great job.
Absolutely.
And, you got to give them their credit. They've been able to maintain and have some continuity, which unfortunately we haven't been able to do. Continuing to flip the roster year in and year out, and it's been a bit of a struggle, but. Maybe we can retain a few 4 or 5 guys going into next year, and maybe we can kind of get this ship on the right path.
Oh, we're not going to quite give up.
We're going to keep praying.
No. Well, I'm not saying you're giving up. I'm not going to quite give up. We're going to keep praying, and you guys going to keep working it, because if I know you, it's not over until the last horn. So we're going to keep it going. You get off to your last road trip this weekend.
Right.
How do you go into that with a disappointing loss like this? Going to Pine Bluff, who's going to be tough there?
They're tough. Everybody's tough. Everybody.
Yeah, we talked about it.
Everybody's
in the beginning.
Tough, right? And you just got to go play. You got to go get ready. You got to prepare the same way. I learned that from Coach Saban. Nothing changes. You just got to go harder, and you just got to be a little bit more committed. You got to do a better job on the glass. You got to get some of these senior guys to step up and take and make some shots, and kind of maybe not put the team on their back, but you got to assume a leadership position. But nothing changes for me. I only know one way. That's
win.
To prepare the same way, work hard, bust it, and get ready to get on the road.
Absolutely.
And go play Pine Bluff and Valley.
Well, Coach, good luck as you get on the road.
Thank you.
These guys are playing with a lot of passion. We just got to put together the full package.
Right.
Friends, that's going to wrap it up for us here in the William Nix Center. It's been an exciting night and enjoyable night. We'd like to thank all of you who view us, Coach. We have not had this many views, I don't think, since I've been here.
That's great.
I mean, like 3,000 and 4,000 every time we come on. And mm-hmm. we sincerely thank you. Our athletic director thanks you. Our senior women administrator, Miss Alicia Pete, thanks you. Anton Goff, thanks you. Miss Latonya Thurston, thank you. And, hey, Donald Carroll and I, we love you. So stick around, folks. Come on back and continue to watch exciting Panther sports right here on the Prairie View A&M University YouTube channel. That's going to wrap it up for us. Good night.